Hello everybody, welcome to video class. How are you? Okay, today I am going to discuss Indian Penal Code Chapter 9 of the IPC of offences by or relating to public servants. Okay. This chapter deals with two classes of offenses, okay, of which one can be committed by public servants alone, and the other comprises offenses which relate to public servants, though they are not committed by them. Okay, here some provision was deleted by the Prevention of Corruption Act 1988. So some provisions deletion. Which provision? Actually, this chapter deals with section 161 to 170. So with effect 9/9/1988, section 161 to section 165A stand omitted by the Prevention of Corruption Act 1988. Okay, so the relevant portion from the statement of objects and reasons appended to the Prevention of Corruption Act 1988 relating to the omission, okay, 161 to 165 A of IPC. So now we are going to discuss section 166 onwards, section 166 to 170 of the IPC. Section 166 explained about public servant disobeying law with intent to cause injury to any person. Okay, so section 166 saying that, and whoever being a public servant knowingly disobeys any direction of the law as to the way in which he is to conduct himself as such public servant, intending to cause or knowing it to be likely that he will by such disobedience cause injury to any person, shall be punished with simple imprisonment for a term. Okay, you know very well, simple imprisonment, procedure of the imprisonment we already studied in introduction part. Okay, so which may extend to 1 year or with the fine or with both. So those who are disobeying public servants, automatically the IPC says imprisonment extended to 1 year. Okay, one illustration we'll discuss, then only we come to know what above stated, the public servant disobeying law with intent to cause injury to any person. So how related this illustration, I will discuss with you. A is a person, being an officer, A being an officer directed by law. Any other person directed by law. Directed by law means court directions or any one of the court pass the order in civil suit or criminal cases, whatever it may be. Okay, here this illustration, A being an officer directed by law to take property in execution. In order to satisfy a degree pronounced in Z favor. Z is another person because his degree is civil court. So this degree is equivalent to award, judgment, something like whatever it may be, the finality of the order. Okay, so in civil suit, all the judgment as per the CPC direction only degree. Okay, here A being an officer directed by law to take property in execution in order to satisfy a degree pronounced in Z's favor by a court of justice. Okay, knowingly, you just note down, knowingly disobeys the direction of law with the knowledge that he is likely thereby to cause injury to Z. So here A has committed the offense defined in this section. Okay, this is what saying section 161 of IPC. So here disobedience of law by public servant, the offense under this section consists in a willful departure from the direction of the law, including to cause injury to any person, mere breach of departmental rules will not bring a public servant within the purview of this section. And another ingredients of the 161, the main ingredients, okay? The main ingredients means the motive. So, number one, four ingredients are available, IPC 161. Number one, the accused was a public servant at the relevant time. Number one. Number two, there was a direction of a law as to how such public servant should conduct himself. Number three, the accused had disobeyed the such direction. Here, who is the accused? The public servant. Because he is not obeying the court order. And fourth point, by such disobedience, he had intent to cause or knew it would likely cause injury to any person. Now it clear? So these are all ingredients included in this illustration. Okay. And the indispensable ingredient of the offense is that the offender should have done the act being a public servant. The next ingredient close to its heels is that such public servant has acted in disobedience of any legal direction concerning the way in which he should have conducted as such public servant. For the offense under section 167 and 219 of Indian Penal Code, the pivotal ingredient is the same as for the offense under section 166 of Indian Penal Code. If in carrying out the direction of law, the accused gave information which according to the complainant was untrue, that by itself cannot attract the offense punishable under section 166 IPC, unless it is shown that the replies given by the accused were untrue. Point number one, when an investigating officer recorded his satisfaction in writing that the search of a particular premises was necessary because disputed document might be found there. His entry into such premises was held to be not in disobedience of law, and therefore he could not be prosecuted without sanction under section 197 of Criminal Procedure Code. Now it clear? And another third point, to make out an offence under this provision, it has to be stated that the public servant knowingly disobeyed any particular direction of the law which he was bound to obey, and further that such disobedience would cause injury to any person to the knowledge of the public servant. Here, a perusal of the complaint does not disclose any particular act or omission of any of the officer of the Bihar State Electricity Board, because it is not disputed that the officers of the board will be public servant within the meaning of definition of the term in the penal code. Okay, here we discussed the sanction, previous sanction. Okay, so what is the previous sanction? As the offence under section 166 and 167 of the Indian Penal Code have a direct nexus with the commission of a criminal misconduct on the part of a public servant, indisputably an order of sanction was a pre-request before the learned judge or judicial magistrate could issue summon upon the accused. The reference case, P.K. Chowdhury versus Commander. Okay, now it's clear, section 166. We'll go to another section. Just a break.